Hey everyone, this is Ayman, and I wanted to do a recap or upload a video to YouTube since I didn't do one for a while. And on this recap, I am going to explain in short the way I'm looking for my breakout trades, how I identify the target levels, and how I catch the setup intraday. So let's do this way. The only stock I traded today was PLTR. As you can see, I had multiple stocks on my watch list: Apple, AMD, and I had my plan written in it. Breakout above 134, breakout above 83.90. I had BA also planned for 3-bar play on the daily chart. I had Microsoft for a possible trend continuation. To the long side, I had Nvidia and I had PLTR. The only thing which actually set up and gave me the perfect pattern was PLTR, and it was the only one I executed the trade on. There is no plan around here because I just deleted everything I had on my charts just to draw it all from the beginning when I will be explaining my setup. So let's start. This is what I saw on the daily chart. This was it in the pre-market with a candle around here. The first thing I am doing is identify the possible direction on the daily chart. Looking at the daily chart around here, you could see that we are slightly uptrending. So overall, the chart is going to the upwards, but you could see that around here, we are chopping. The last two candles are giving me a small hint of where today we might go to. Look at this. We're having a hammer, 21st of June, and we're having another hammer at 22nd of June. Today, we're opening closer to the breakout area, which is here, and having those candles around here is indicating that today we are more likely to go to the long side. Perfect. I identified the possible direction of the daily chart, then I go to the smaller time frame, which is the 60-minute chart. On the 60-minute chart, I zoom it out and I try to identify the possible resistance levels. When we were around here, I definitely didn't like this stock for any trade. Why is that? Because we are sitting literally at the resistance area. Therefore, I decided that I want to take a breakout on this trade exactly the moment we break this level. What was the target? The first target for me was this level. The next target was the average true range. Now, before that, let's go back to the daily chart and take a look at this. Chart area, add new area before, study config, average true range, and look at this. This around here is telling us how much the stock could run intraday. And around here, you could see that on average, PLTR moves somewhere around $1 intraday. Going to the 60-minute chart again, you could see that the beginning of the move in the pre-market, you could see this is the lowest point we had. This is the pre-market actually. The, 23rd pre-market. The lowest point was at 25.30, right? So the highest point, according to the average true range on the daily chart, not the 60-minute chart, the highest point is 26.30. So we're having two targets. First target, the high of the 60-minute chart. The second target is the high of the day. Going to the smaller time frames, and basically this is our third hint, is check for a pattern in the pre-market. In the pre-market, if we take a look at PLTR, basically there was literally no pattern. It was just chopping around, going around view, chopping around view up. Let's zoom it in and go basically to the pre-market. There it is, our pre-market. There it is. And you could perfectly see that there is no pattern. Therefore, I didn't rush any trade in this thing. Finally, wait for a setup after market open. And this is the market open. You could see the stock, first of all, dropped down. It gave us a fake breakdown, squeezed all the way up. This is the level, the breakout area. Played it to the long side, partial at the first target. Then I am coming to my rules on the 5-minute chart. After a big move, basically two big 5-minute candles, there is usually a pullback. And if you remember my ABCD pattern webinar, the pullback is usually into the 9 EMA on the 5-minute chart. That's why I didn't rush an add around here or around here on the 1-minute chart. I waited for the pullback to the 9, waited for a new 5-minute high, added to my position, and then held it to my final target, which is the average true range. Let's get back to the 1-minute chart and look at this. On the 1-minute chart, you could see perfectly that, okay, why didn't I add around here on the 1-minute chart at a bounce of view up after a confirmation candle, which was the hammer? The main reason I didn't add is what I talked about a few minutes ago. On the 5-minute chart, this was the first 5-minute candle, 5 candles. This is the second 5-minute candle around here. And you see that we're making higher highs and higher lows. and I told you that I'm waiting for a pullback. The pullback is basically a lower low and lower high on the 5-minute chart. This is the next 5-minute candle. And then finally, we are having the lower low and lower high on the 5-minute chart. We're bouncing off the 9 EMA on the 5-minute chart. And I am playing it to the long set on a new 5-minute high, finally targeting the average true range. So basically, this is in short the way I am looking for breakouts intraday. Take a look at the daily chart, identify the direction. Take a look at the 60-minute chart, identify the target levels, and make sure you get at least 2-to-1 before the first resistance you have. Find a setup on the 5 or on the 1-minute chart, get your entry, and then play your plan. Now, one last thing. Some might say, why don't you mark this as a level around here? Basically, the way I mark my levels, I go from the closest to the farther, point I have. And you can see the closest point we have, or the closest level we have around here. Next level we're having around here, and basically then it goes lower. So I don't mark these levels around here. If we go, for example, on NVDA, what will be my levels? Let's zoom it in to the pre-market. There is the pre-market, and let's go back. So basically on NVDA, this will be the first level we have. This is market open, so let's ignore it. This would be the first level we have. Then after that, you go a little bit higher and you have this level around here. Then you go a little bit higher and you have this level around here. And then finally you go around here. I will not be marking the levels which were back then. If you go to Microsoft, Microsoft is at all-time high, not really interesting. BA, for example, closest level is around here. Then you go back and it is around here, right? I will not go back and mark those levels around here or these levels around here. You could go further, by the way, and you could mark the levels above, but you don't mark the levels below. Now, those levels, they do really matter, but they are not as strong. So yeah, that's it, guys. If you like the recap, please feel free to put a like, comment here. If you have any suggestions, feel free to type them in the comment section. I always check them. And if you have any questions, feel free to email me, aiman@beerbulltraders.com. Have a great day, everyone, and I'll see you in the chat room tomorrow.